What makes cheese so delicious? It's the bacteria, fungi, and mites living on it, of course. I'm Anna Rothschild, and this is Gross Science. Cheeses come in a variety of different forms. They can be soft, hard, mild, stinky, you name it. But if you look at the label, most cheeses are made of the same handful of ingredients. There's milk, salt, a slurry of enzymes called rennet, and bacteria. At its most basic, cheese is really just curdled milk with some of the liquid removed. Mixing in bacteria allows the curds to ferment, and different strains of bacteria can create a diversity of flavors and textures. For example, Swiss cheese is made using a strain of bacteria that releases carbon dioxide during fermentation. The CO2 gets trapped, causing those characteristic holes to form. And the odor of smelly feet emanating from Limburger cheese comes from a species that's closely related to one living on human feet, thus the similar smell. You can create other varieties of cheese by adding fungus to the mix. For example, blue cheese wouldn't even be blue without the spores of the fungus Penicillium roqueforti, and cheesemakers poke holes in blue cheese to allow the fungus to breathe and grow. The outsides of cheeses are crawling with even more life. Cheese rinds are essentially biofilms. They're communities of microorganisms that include bacteria and fungi from the environment that are attracted to the cheese as it ages. In fact, there are whole labs at places like Harvard that are studying how these funky communities form and interact. And that's not all. Cheeses can also be covered in mites, which eat the fungal tendrils in cheese rinds. In some varieties, they're seen as a pest, but in others, like Mimolette, they're actually specifically added to give the cheese a particular flavor. To top it off, on the island of Sardinia, there's a delicacy called casu marzu, which literally means rotten cheese. Before it's eaten by humans, it's feasted on by the larva of the cheese fly, which makes it very soft and pungent. Many diners will eat the delicacy, live maggots and all. This all might sound super nasty, but so many of our favorite foods are made in similar ways. Bread, wine, yogurt, pickles, they're all made by letting other organisms, like yeast and bacteria, digest parts of our food before we do. And frankly, if it means I get to keep eating Parmesan on my pasta, I'm happy to embrace the creepy crawlies living in it. Ew. Got a question about any of the organisms living in cheese? Let me know in the comments. And for more gross science, hit subscribe.